morning. Time 6:40, walking down through Woodbridge. Town is quiet. Exciting times. I'm off to go and pick up a new car. Why am I standing at 7 o'clock in the morning in the drizzle in rural Suffolk on a train station travelling to Manchester? Clio. I really like them. I've got a little Clio diesel van and it's been brilliant, really good workhorse, really cheap, paid a few hundred quid for it, although, and I'll cover that in another video. I was taking it round Wales a week or so ago with some friends and I was comprehensively out horsepowered following a TVR T350T, an Audi R8 V10 Plus, Lexus LCF Coupe, etc, etc. I was left behind, I was taken for dust. I miss having a hot hatchback, so did some research, had a look round, joined the Clio Sport Forum and found the little car that I'm travelling up to Manchester to pick up. It's a black gold Clio with some nice tasty mods, IBAC suspension, upgraded brakes, different wheels, good tyres, not paying a vast amount of money for it. Hopefully it's as described. I'm never going to say it's an investment. We all know that's bollocks. But it should be fun. Should be a nice drive back. So it's going to be a long day. It's 7 a.m. I'm standing in the drizzle on Woodbridge train station. Update to follow.
Down Euston Road, 1 hour 5 minutes late. Now walking between Euston Square, Euston Station, and hope my ticket's still valid.
Sunny Manchester, running late. Joys of being held at signals just outside Manchester Piccadilly, so you miss your connecting train. Sorted it, going to a different station, being met there, all is good. Back on track for Clio Collection. Where are we? I'm just south of Shrewsbury, running through Wales, absolutely loving it. I have travelled somewhere around about 84 miles since I picked the car up. Not missed a beat, absolutely superb. It's as noisy as hell, hard ride, great suspension, road holding is superb. I'm loving it, it's great. As you can see, I'm standing here with a Renault Clio Sport 182 behind me. Picked it up yesterday. I was going to do a little walk around video of it, but it was really grubby, and I wanted to get on with driving it, to be brutally honest. It's a right hoot. It's fast, it's noisy, it's antisocial, it handles beautifully. As you can see, it doesn't scrub up too bad either.
Let's roll.
Not a bad place to be. Car looks quite at home. First impressions. Had it for 24 hours, drove back from Manchester, run through South Wales. It's brilliant. Cars are cheap, is the best way I can describe it. Less than £2,000 for 182 horsepower, hot hatchback with sport suspension. Decent tyres, they've got Toyo Proxes all round, good tread. Team Dynamics lightweight wheels, so uprated brakes, braided hoses, air conditioning blows cold, the cruise control still works, so much for French car electrics being a bit pants. Hasn't used any oil. I drove in a spirited fashion across Wales yesterday to go pick up some more wheels for it. Manchester down to Cwmbran in Wales, across the Triff Forest, had a quick look round in the mountains. Bit of a hoon, back on the M4, M25, A12, 37.8 miles per gallon. Can't fault that for the day. It's been remapped, so it runs on V-Power, so you've got to put decent fuel in it. But yeah, I'll give you another report in a few days. But so far, so
good. Yeah, it really is a bit of a privilege to drive around this site. It's an old Cold War airbase in Suffolk. It's now privately owned. If you can spot any odd bits in the background, like portaloos and tents, there was a big scout camp held on here last weekend, and they don't normally let people drive their cars around here, but I've been given permission, and it's great. I'm on a runway. Mustn't. Gotta be good. Got to be good.